Do you want the all-out babies or do you want the chill babies? Like, what do you want?
Fly with the stars in the skies. I am no longer trying to survive. I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire. It's my
hey YouTube, I am back with another. Someone yesterday at work told me hitting the wall is like you're tying a knot around someone. But anyways, back again with another video. And it is a 2-month update on her hair company, right? I believe so, I hope so. If not, I will change that. But whoever's hair it is good hair because I am rocking with it. It's been a little over 2 months. I got it in May 11th, and it's now July 21st, so it's been a little over 2 months and I still feel the same way I felt when I first put it in. I feel like I just got it installed. It doesn't even look like it needs to be reinstalled, but I will be probably taking it out in another month just cause it's getting a little loose. But for the most part, it maintains its curl, its bounce, its movement. Like it's still big and fluffy, but I have it to where it's maintained a little more in like the wet look. The only thing that I necessarily have a problem with is my leave out, and that's just my hair. I have to consistently keep it wet or maybe puff up the weave hair. My curl pattern is it dries up so quick and shrivels up, so I really had to learn to stretch my curl to make sure it matches, because this kind of falls into a wave and my hair is like doo-doo-doo. So I don't know if you could kind of you can't really tell, but I can tell. But yeah, what I was talking about, I'm gonna get a little closer so you can see. This is my hair. So like it kind of goes, and maybe I could comb through the weave hair and make it a little bigger, and then maybe it will like puff out and you won't be able to tell. That could work. But even then, like you can't really tell. Like I can only tell because I be doing the most and I can see it all, but I would 100% recommend this hair. You might need to use a lot of products in order to maintain it and to tame it down so it's not like huge. I know I've seen some videos of girls who had the same hair and it was like this big, and if you want to rock it that way, that's fine, but I just like the wet look. And also another tip, if this doesn't stop poking through, I'll just like bobby pin it like that and then it's fine. I got up to what, 22 or 24 inches, and it's past, a little past my boob. I might get different lengths next time, like maybe 2 24s, because I don't like how that, I don't know if you guys remember when I showed you me diffusing my hair in the previous video, how the puffiness up here didn't match down here, so I might get another 24 just so it can match a little better. But overall, yeah, great hair, great company, no complaints. 10 out of 10, would recommend. Thanks. And then also, if you have any hair companies or types of hair textures, or even like, not textures, but styles like body wave or straight, or this one's obviously curly, that you would like me to try and just see how they look on my hair, I'm always down for a new style. So, or if you would like me to style this hair a certain way, maybe you want to see it, just comment down below, let me know, and I'll definitely get another video out for that. Thanks. I just recorded me styling my hair, how I do it. So I'll definitely post that so you can see how to make it look like super blended. I can put a hat on, I can wear it in pigtails. I've been braiding it a lot. I always braid it when I go to sleep. Yeah, I can even like pin it like this and it's fine. Like, I don't know if I said like so many times, but it's like the best hair ever. But yeah. Will I be reinstalling it? Probably so. I don't think I need to buy new hair because it's still bouncy and it's not tangled. I show a little video of me combing through it and how it does shed, but it's curly hair, like you gotta get used to that. So yeah, thanks for watching. Okay, so what you're first going to wanna do the night before, or like whenever you're going to bed, or at least this is what I like to do, I put my hair in two braids. The reason I put them in two braids is because when I had a curly weave a couple years ago, it got very matted in the back, and I think I kind of have a video of that on my YouTube, but it got really matted and I had to like cut a lot of the hair out, and it irked me. So what you see me doing here is just unbraiding both sides and making sure that it isn't tangled whatsoever. I know I look crazy, but it's all good. Okay, so right now, I know I look a hot mess, but it's okay because we're gonna get there. What I like to first do before I do anything is create my part for my hair. So obviously this is my leave out. I hike you like a chicken hair right now, but it's all good, like I said. We're gonna get it right. So I create this part with a rat tooth comb. And the part is really important because that's where your tracks can show. And I always felt before I even got a weave, like I would look at people who had fake hair and their part was just so jank. Like you could see their tracks. So I feel like that's a super important part. Make sure it's straight. And also because you decide where your baby hairs go based off of where you put your part. So always make sure you have a good amount of hair wherever you lay it. So that way it looks more natural. All right, so next thing I do personally is I use the heck out of this spray bottle. The braids kept it from getting tangled, so now I can just wet it and comb through it, hopefully. Uh-oh, so we got a little nick. Just comb right through it. Honestly, don't be afraid to comb through your curly hair, because it's gonna need it. Like, don't be afraid of the shedding. It happens, like, it's fine. Take care of it, obviously, but don't be upset when, like, some hair comes out, because it is what it is. You already got it. It's curly hair. That's what happens. Your hair gets tangled. Get used to it. So, that part never really bothered me about the hair.
Okay, and so I just finished combing through and I show you how much hair actually did come out, and honestly, from me combing through it, not much even came out. So once it's all wet, I take my rat tooth comb and I just go over the part again and make sure it's good with the water.
Okay, so after it's all soaking wet pretty much, that's when I wanna put the conditioner on. I put the conditioner on at this point because when it dries, it'll hold the lotion moisture. And I honestly don't even know if that is what happens, but that's what my hair does, so that's what I'm gonna do. And then I finger comb through it like so. That way I can get through all of it. What I'm really trying to do is just make sure my hair matches the curl pattern of the weave hair. And as you can see, it kind of already is. But this comb through, I think, really helps make it stay for that initial stretch. If you can see right here, it's still kind of curling up, but it's getting there. We're getting there, people. We're getting there.
All right, so next you'll see me using the Eco Styling Gel Argan Oil. I'm not typically a advocate for gel. I don't really even use it unless I'm like trying to lay my hair down, especially having a different curl pattern. But this styling gel doesn't seem to contain any alcohol or anything really detrimental to your like hair growth or hair journey. So maybe it is a good option to buy, but if possible, avoid gels because they can dry out your hair. Next, you see me basically combing through my hair, and essentially I'm just stretching it out with the gel, hoping that it will match the curl pattern of the weave hair. I also recently started using mousse. Instead of diffusing my hair, I found that I could put mousse on it and it worked practically the same. But I have heard that mousse can also dry out and damage your hair, so definitely be cautious using that. I prefer the fructis over the tresemme one. I'm not sure if it's the smell or the consistency, but it did feel better on my hair, less crunchy.
All right, combed through it. Now is the fun part. Now we get to lay the baby hairs, because although the hair is matching pretty nicely, this needs to be fixed, okay? So I usually have a better toothbrush than this, but yes, I do use a toothbrush. It's not that weird. Just don't use the same one you use for your teeth. And that depends on what kind of babies you want that day. Like, do you want the all-out babies or do you want the chill babies? Like, what do you want?
Okay, so here I am basically doing a swooping motion, and I'm using gel to apply the baby and lay the baby hairs down. I use gel because it allows me to kind of maneuver and move my hair a little bit more, rather than if I use edge control, it kind of constricts it. So if the gel isn't like working very well, or if I just need some extra control, I'll put the edge control over it, but I usually can get away with just using gel. Now, after I use the brush, I'm gonna use a comb, and that honestly really helps define the baby hairs, and it just looks way better when you use a comb. And I'm not quite sure why it took so long for me to even use a comb. So if you don't use a comb, definitely try and see if it looks better for your hair. This side of my head isn't super important because my hair pretty much covers it, but I always do both sides just to make sure all my edges are laid. Like, that's a must. Here I do a nice swooping motion, and then I kind of pull through, if that makes sense. I like swoop and then pull the comb back. Now that my hair is ready, I can finally get ready. I just want to know, you guys, do you normally do your hair first or do you get dressed first? I typically get dressed first, but having a weave is a lot to maintain, so I found myself doing my hair first way more often now. Also, I put a bobby pin in to hold my curls down.
Okay, so I know I just did a hair tutorial on like how I style it and keep it wet and curly. As you can see, this is the reason why I do that. My leave out is still like somewhat tame, but do you see the difference in how my hair is and how this hair is?
I also would like to know, is there a way, like, do any of you guys know a better way to keep my hair the same pattern as the weave hair, besides water and conditioner? Any tips and tricks you guys might have, drop them down below. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. I appreciate it. Thank you.